Welcome to Erudite Education. We drive to seek knowledge.
Erudite Education. We drive to seek knowledge. So, we are done with our topic of integers from the arithmetic section from the GRE Quantitative Reasoning section. Now, what we are going to do in this particular lesson is I have a few practice questions. If you guys have gone through my previous video, you must be knowing that I had left a Google form over there wherein I had some practice questions for the part as well. For the divisibility test part that was remaining, I'd be covering the questions up over here in this particular lesson. So what we are going to discuss is there are 5 practice questions, very easy, and they're all based on the divisibility tests. So what we are going to do is we are going to discuss that practice questions over here. First, you guys need to solve those questions by yourself. In case you are not understanding or in case you are stuck somewhere, then you can go through the solutions part that I'll be discussing over here in this particular lesson. So I hope you guys have gone through all the previous videos. If you haven't, then you should check them out, because with this particular video, the topic of integers from the arithmetic section would be done, and then we'd be moving on to another section for the fractions and decimals. So this is the last part from the topic integers. So our first question for today. So the first question for today says, when a positive integer is divided by 45, the remainder is 18. So which of the following must be a divisor of n? So there is some positive integer n which is divided by 45 and the remainder comes out to be 18. So we had studied one formula at the beginning of the last lesson, which was actually dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is what exactly we are going to use over here. It is a very simple question. So I have some positive integer n that is being divided. So obviously n is going to be my dividend. So my divisor is 45 because I am dividing n by 45. So divisor is 45. Let the quotient q be anything. I am considering it as an alphabet q. And the remainder they have given in the question is 18. So I can write this statement as n equal to 45 into q plus 18. Now I can take 9 common from this entire section. So I am taking 9 common out. I get 5 plus 2q inside. Now there's one thing over here, that irrespective of whatever is the value of q, my value of n will always be divisible by 9, because there are two terms over here. One is 9 and one is 5 plus 2q, and both are in multiplication. So irrespective of whatever would be my answer of my value of q, my n will always be divisible by 9. So that is why I can say that n 9 should always be a divisor of this particular equation. So 9 will always divide the positive integer n. So that is how simple this question was. There's another same question, kind of same question, which says, if 617 is being divided by 49, then what is the sum of the tens and the tenths digit? Now if you're aware of the fact what is tenths digit, what is hundredths digit, then you would know that this question is very, very simple. Only the thing that you have to do is you have to divide correctly 617 upon 49. So when you divide 617 by 49, you get the answer as 12.59. I'm rounding it out to 12.6 because I need the tenths digit. They have not asked me about the hundredths digit or the thousandths digit. So there's one thing over here. Suppose you consider a number 42.96. So 4 over here in 42 is my tenths digit. 2 is my units place digit. Then I have 0.96. So whatever comes after the decimal part becomes a tenths digit. You can see your T, E and THS. So 42.96, my 9 is my tenths digit, 6 is my hundredths digit. So it goes on, tenths, hundredths, thousands and so on. So tenths digit as in the digit that comes right after the decimal point. So over here if I consider 5 is my tenths digit, 9 is my hundredths digit. But since they have not talked about the hundredths digit, I only have to consider the tenths digit. So that is actually 12.6 because I have to round off 0.59 to 6. So it becomes 12.6. So I can say my tenths ka digit is 1 and tenths place digit is 6. So the sum of both the digits comes out to be 7. So the correct answer over here in this particular slide is actually 7. So it was a very simple question. I hope you guys have understood. If you know the concept, you can easily answer this question. The next question says, there are multiples of in set A, you have a multiples of 5 from 1 to 20. So the multiples of 5 would be 5, 10, 15 and 20. I have written over here. Set B says odd numbers less than 20. So there would be 10 odd numbers, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17 and 19. So 10 odd numbers in total. And in set C, would be having every element from 1 to 100, that is product of one element from A and one other element from B. So you will have one element from A being multiplied with another element from B, and you have to carry out this multiplication until the number is before 100. So between the range of 1 to 100 will be the number. So let's consider this element 5 from set A. So 5 I can multiply with all the numbers over here. The maximum number I'll get would be 5 into 19, which is 95. So right from 1 to 19, I can multiply 5 with any number. For the number 10, I can have the maximum multiple is 90. So I can take any numbers from 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So for 5, we had 10 numbers. For 10, we have 5 numbers. For 15, the maximum product between the range 1 to 100 can be 90. So that becomes 15 into 6. We have 1, 3, 5. That can we can consider for 15. And for 20, you can have the maximum product again as 100. So 20 into 5 is equal to 100. So from set B, you will have 1, 3 and 5 only. So I can say that I can have a maximum of 5 plus 10 numbers we had. So 10 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3, that means 21 numbers. So 21 is not neither of these options. So what we need to do is we have to cut it down. Now how are you going to cut it down? Actually what happens is you have two numbers over here. That is 5 and 15, jinke multiple same aayenge, so that means they will have common multiples. For example, 5 into 9 is 45, and 15 into 3 is also 45. So 45 would be repeated. Similarly, 15 into 5 is 75, and 5 into 15 is also 75. So 75 we cancel ho jayega. There's one more such factor over here, like we have 5 into 3 as 15 and 15 into 1 is 15, so even 15 would get cancelled. So these are all the numbers 15, 45 and 75 that will get cancelled, because both 5 into 3 and 15 into 1 will give me the same number. Again 5 into 15 and 15 into 5 will give me the same number. Again I'll have 15 into 3 and 5 into 9 giving me the same number. So these three are the common factors. So after the 21 numbers that we had calculated, 3 will get cancelled. So that means I have 18 numbers remaining. So though I can say that I have in set C, I'll be having 18 numbers. Answers this particular question. In the next question, they say they have a set A wherein you have even numbers from 1 to 100. You have a set B where you have numbers divisible by 5 from 1 to 100. So how many numbers from A are not going to be members of B? So let's see, if you are considering even numbers from 1 to 100, let's take a small range. From 1 to 10, you will have 5 even numbers. So 10 such sets from 1 to 10 will make me 1 to 100, will give me 1 to 100. So I can say that I can have 5 into 10, that is 50 numbers, 50 even numbers between 1 to 100. So that means my set A will consider of 50 even numbers. Now if you consider the set B, you will have numbers that are divisible by 5, that means 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Now agar aap consider karte ho, you will have 5, you will have 15, you will have 25. These are not actually even numbers, so these numbers actually get cancelled. So the rest of the numbers, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, up to 100, that means there are 10 such numbers in set B that are common in set A, but the total numbers in set A was already 50. And we had 10 common numbers from set A and set B, so these are to be taken out. So I'll have 50 minus 10, that is 40 remaining numbers. So I can say there are 40 numbers from A which are not actually the members of B, because the remaining 10 numbers are actually common numbers. So 40 becomes the correct answer for this question. The next one is when x is divided by 3, the remainder is 1. So again, we are going to use the formula dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Let's first read the entire question. The next one says when x is divided by 7, you have the remainder as 2. So how many such positive integers less than 100 can be the values of x? So they have given you two equations, and you have to find out how many positive integers less than 100 can be the values of x. So in my first equation, I get x equals to 3 into q plus 1, because 3 is my divisor, x is my dividend, and I have taken some quotient q. You can take the quotient as q1 and the remainder is 1, so I'm adding the remainder. For the second case, I have my dividend as x, I have my divisor as 7, and I have my quotient as suppose q2. Let's take this as q dash and not q, because both q's won't be equal. And then I have the remainder as 2, so I'll add the remainder 2 as well. So I have two equations for x. The first is x equals to 3q1 plus 1, and the second is x equals to 7q2 plus 2. Now start substituting values of q1 as 1, 2, 3 and so on. So for q1 equals to 1, you will have x equals to 4. For q1 equals to 2, you will have x equals to 7. For q1 equals to 3, you will have x equal to 10. So you find a pattern over here that every consecutive number that is coming up is actually 3 plus the previous number. So 4, 7, 10, 13, 16 and so on, the series is going to increase till 100. In the second case, if you take q2 as 1, you will have 7 plus 2 which is equal to 9. If you take q2 as 2, you will have 16. If you take q2 as 3, you will have 23. So 9, 16, 23, 30 and so on. You can see that every two consecutive numbers have a difference of 7. So the next upcoming number will actually be 7 plus the previous number. Now you can see over here that there are few numbers repeating. For example, I have 16 and 16 over here. Again, then I have another number repeating which is 37. The next number, if you see the difference between these two numbers is 21. So the next repeating number would be 37 plus 21 which is 58. You can check it out yourself. Again, the next repeating number would be 58 plus 21 that is 79. So there is a similar difference between any two numbers that is coming up. So these are the four numbers that the next number you will have would be actually 79 plus 21 that is 100. But they have asked you values which are less than 100, so you do not need to consider 100. So you can see that from the range of 1 to 100 there will be four numbers which would be satisfied by these two equations. So they have given you both the options, so 4 and 5. If you consider 100, you would go wrong because they have asked you numbers less than 100 which most of the people ignore. So the correct answer over here would be 4. You can use any other shortcut method as well. You can use 3q1 plus 1 equals to 7q2 plus 2 and you can check with the different values, but I feel this is the most easiest and the safest way you would be playing with this particular question. So that was all about questions for integers. You guys must have observed that though the questions are very very simple, but they are something that consumes a lot of time, and one mistake and you would be wrong with the entire question and you would lose out on the marks. So it is better that you practice such kind of questions more and more because you get acquainted to the concepts, and then when such kind of different question comes in front of you, you will be able to answer it very easily without making any mistakes and in very less time as well. So that was it for this particular lesson. I would be taking up the topic of fractions and decimals in my upcoming lesson. So don't forget to hit on the subscribe button if you like the video. If you are getting benefited from the video, do like, share and comment my video, and also suggest me whatever topics you need and I would make sure that I cover those topics in my videos. Thank you so much for watching, and do hit the like button and share my videos, and also do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day, you guys.